Hi, welcome back. I'm Roxanne, Super Doodle Girl, and in this video, you'll learn to embrace your inner child's playfulness while practicing watercolor skills. We'll create a delightfully spooky and wonky Halloween scene with simple tools and techniques. Start by lightly sketching our spooky house. Remember, we're not aiming for perfection here. This house has seen better days. Instead of straight lines and right angles, I want you to think crooked and wonky. Imagine the house has settled unevenly throughout the years. Let your lines waver and tilt. This adds to the eerie atmosphere we're creating. Keep your pencil strokes light at this stage. Don't worry about erasing. We can refine these lines when we ink later. The goal now is to capture the overall shape and feel of our haunted house. As you sketch, I want you to picture stories this whole house could tell. Each crooked window and sagging roofline adds to the character of our spooky scene. Now let's add some spooky details to our scene. We'll sketch in a few tombstones. You know, nothing says haunted like a personal graveyard, right? And don't forget the big gaping hole in our tree trunk, perfect for hiding secrets or maybe a little ghostly resident. For an extra touch, we'll have a skeleton peeking out from behind the middle tombstone. Remember, we're going for whimsical spooky, so feel free to give that skeleton a bit of personality. Time to switch gears. I'm reaching for my Le Pen fine liner. The 0.5 tip is perfect for these outlines. This part requires a bit more patience than our initial sketching. Take your time to study each line, making small adjustments as you go. Now, as you ink, remember those shaky lines. We do want a wonky, whimsical quality to our drawing. Think of each wobbly line as adding character to our quirky haunted house. After all, we're creating a whimsical, spooky scene, not an architectural blueprint. Don't worry if your lines aren't perfect. That's part of the charm. Let your pen dance a little as you outline, adding those delightful imperfections that bring our spooky house to life. Or should I say afterlife?
Thank you.
Time to amp up the spookiness. Let's add a giant full moon looming behind our haunted house. It will set the perfect eerie backdrop. And now let's ink those tombstones at the bottom. Let's get them crooked and quirky. This is a whimsical graveyard after all. And how about a little zombie hand popping up for another spooky detail? Now don't forget that tree on the left. Remember that big hole we sketched? Let's draw some mysterious eyes peeking out. Keep it subtle. We want viewers to wonder what's hiding in there. The beauty of this scene is in those little pops of mystery. Those eyes could be anything, and that's what makes it delightfully spooky. And now for the fun part. Adding little critters to our spooky scene. I'm drawing inspiration from Ed Emberley's charming style for these whimsical spooky creatures. Let's add bats in the sky, creepy crawly spiders, grinning skeletons, and wise old owls perched on tree branches. Remember, these little guys don't need to be complex. Emberley's style is all about simple shapes coming together to create lovable characters, so have fun with it. Each creature adds its own personality to our haunted scene.
Thank you.
And of course, remember a crooked fence with some little spikes on top for one more little detail in our scene. After you finish inking and adding all the details into your scene, grab an eraser and now let's erase all of our pencil marks and then get our watercolors out and we'll add color to the page. For this piece, I'm using the Core Intensity Watercolor Set by Golden. These paints are fantastic. Their clear binder allows for incredibly bright and strong colors whenever I want them. I've also got my trusty ceramic palette with my three favorite Echoline colors ready to go. We'll be doing quite a bit of color mixing to achieve the perfect spooky palette. Let's start by bringing our haunted house to life with some warm glowing colors for the windows and the moon. I'm using the Echo Line 201 as a base. And then mixing in a touch of the Echo Line 337 to create a rich, eerie orange. To make these areas pop, I'll be picking up additional colors directly from the core pans to intensify the glow. Watch how these colors blend and interact. It's almost like the house is coming alive with an inner supernatural light. The key is to build up the intensity gradually, letting each layer add depth to our spooky scene. As I added the color to the moon, I noticed something weird is going on with the edge of this paper. It's a Canson Heritage, and I have never seen this happen before, but there's this small section about 20 centimeters from the edge, and it's soaking up the paint and not letting it move. And now let's work on the background. I'm planning on using multiple layers. So for the first one, I'm going to use a lot of water in this little neutral color that I've mixed, and I'm going to bring in a little bit of turquoise into it. As we move to the shingles on the roof, I'm looking for a burgundy that can combine the warmth of the orange yellow with the cool blue that's already on the page. So let's explore and see how this turns out.
Thank you.
Ooh, I'm loving how the roof turned out. And now let's move to the facade of the house. As we move into more of a blue that will connect with the roof color, and I'm going to drop in some additional pigment to make some of the areas that are darker, and so we get a little value contrast working here. And now we need some type of brownish color for the tree trunk. I'm going to see what happens when I mix together some purple, orange, and green. And Okay, I'm liking this pretty well. Remember, this page is experimental. I haven't test swatched all the mixes, and I'm working from past experience with these colors to see how I can combine them on the page. So I'm expecting some surprises here.
Thank you.
The house and the trees and the grass turned out pretty well, and now let's tone down this background of that light blue to create a mood that's a bit more mysterious and somber. I want you to keep an eye on that 20 centimeter border and see what happens as I add another layer to it. And now this part of the creative process is where I will continue to add layers of additional watercolor and embellishments using gel pens and some watercolor pencils. So some of my favorites are going to be the glaze pens. I'll be adding those in, and these watercolor pencils are the Faber-Castell. And remember, everything is linked in the description. Next up, let's add some depth and value by lifting some of the watercolor off of the areas of the roof and the front of the tombstones in the house. To do this, just get plain water on your brush, paint it on top of the area that you want to lift some of the color off. I let it set sometimes just for a couple seconds and then get a dry brush, dip it into the little puddle you made, and the color will lift right off the page. I will leave the video real time so you can see how I continue to add details and layer additional color onto this page. Remember, all of the supplies are linked in the description. Thank you. And there you have it, your very own spooky and wonky Halloween watercolor scene. I hope this has inspired you to keep creating every day. If you're committed to developing a consistent art practice and want more tutorials like this, please hit that like button and subscribe to the Super Doodle Girl channel. Your support helps me create more content to keep you motivated on your artistic journey. Remember, a little bit of creativity each day goes a long way. Keep doodling, keep practicing, and I'll see you in the next video.